What is automorphic number? If a number square ends with that number itself, then this number called automorphic number. It is also known as circular number. Let's see example, like 5 square. What is the square of 5? 25. And what is its unit digit? That is 5. Like 6 square, 36. So the unit digit is what? 6. Okay, so these kind of numbers are known as automorphic number. Hello and welcome everyone to Knowledge Circle. And today we will see a program based on automorphic number. So let's copy few lines from the old program and we will write our new program. Okay, so for that we have copied few lines, we have pasted to a new file. Okay, now let's give a new name, let's give the name AMP. Okay, now we will declare the variables. Let's see how many variables are required for this program. We'll take n for accepting the input from user, that will be n for number. Okay, then we need p. Let's keep initial value of p 0. Next is d. We will keep initial value of d as 10. Okay, then let's create object of scanner class, that is sc. Let's give the message that enter a number. Okay, and when the user gives the number, that will be accepted using the next int function into n. Okay, now the next what we are going to type is, we will declare another variable k where we will store the square of the given number. Okay, now let's run the loop. The loop should run till the value of p is lesser than n. Okay, by mistake I did greater, it should be lesser than n. Now we will module the value k, which is the square of the number, by d, means by 10. And whatever the remainder comes, that will be stored in p. Okay, next time what we are going to do, we will multiply d by 10 and we will store again in d. Okay, and when the loop closes, what we get? We get the final value of p. And if p is equal to n, means that the number is automorphic. And if it is not equal, means the condition is false, then we will write that the entered number or the number is not an automorphic number. So let's do that. We will use SOP, and we will, in SOP system.out.println, we will give a message. For that we are putting here n plus, means n concatenation operator, n for the number, and then the message will be is an automorphic number. Okay, after that we'll close the curly braces of if block, then we will write here else, the same message we will copy and paste, and we will have some changes in the sentence. Okay, so that is system.out.println. Let's write here is not an automorphic number. Okay, that we have to do. Let's close curly braces, let's close the main function and the class. Let's go to file and save. Let's write name amp.java. Let's click on save as type, all files, click on save option. Okay, now let's correct it. It's not corrected. Let's write here is not. Okay, let's press Ctrl plus S once more. Let's go to command prompt, type cls. We are already in the folder Java program. Let's type here java c amp.java. Now the program is compiled. Let's execute it. Let's write java amp, enter a number 25. 25 is what? An automorphic number. Let's re-execute it. Let's give another value. Let's give here 61. It's not an automorphic number. Okay, let's execute it once more. Enter a value, 25. It's an automorphic number. Okay, so in this way you can execute it. Like, share and subscribe. And press the bell icon for the latest notification.